Okay.
Right. So, hello, welcome everyone. Thanks for coming to my presentation. I'm Veronica Onfi, as Julien introduced me. First of all, even if Marc de Concha is not here, I would like to thank him for making it possible for me to come, and also to Julien and Emily. So, I am assistant research fellow at the National Agriculture Research and Innovation Center in Hungary. I belong to the Forest Research Institute, and I am based in Sopron. I will show you another picture about it. I studied agricultural engineering in the University of Szent István. It's in Gödöllő. I don't know if you have any of you been to Hungary, by the way? Some of you? Yes? Sure.
Sorry.
Yeah, anyway, so I think Julien said why I'm here and for like the reason here. Actually, the reason why I'm here is because I got a scholarship from Campus France, as I'm a PhD student also, and I got 2 months to spend here. Yes, so just to tell you briefly about agriculture in Hungary. So we are in Central Eastern Europe, and this is my beautiful country. We got temperate climate, a precipitation between 300 millimeter in the lowlands and about 800 millimeter in a mountainous region. They are like very low mountains, that our highest altitude is 1040 meter. We do have adequate sunlight for agricultural production, and but we also have droughts and floods, mainly again in the lowlands. We have some very good fertile soils, the best soils in the world, Volcanosium, and also some acidic soils, which we have a lot of trouble. So we have 93,000 square kilometers. I mean, Hungary is covers that area, and out of this 4.5 million of agricultural land, and about 2 million hectares of forest we have. And agriculture contributes to 4.5% to GDP, which I just saw that it's in France it's 1.5. Is that right? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. Interesting. So about National Agriculture Research and Innovation Center, it was established in 2014. So we are quite a young center in this sense, although many of the research institutions, they are very old, like some of them even over 100 years old. And so we have from biotechnology to agroenvironmental research and the Institute of Agricultural Engineering, as well as the forest research. So about my institute, we have five locations in the country. So when I mentioned that there are some institutes over 100 years old, one of them is the forest research. We have five departments now. I started, I belong to plantation forestry, and I started here. This is Budapest, where I was born and I grew up, and now I am based here because this is where I do my PhD studies. So I also, I asked for to be able to move, because this is actually 400 kilometers away, that I still have to kind of regularly do this distance. So these five departments, this is our headquarter in Sárvár, and this is the one where I started to work in 2015. So we have the five departments: plantation, forestry, tree breeding, forest protection, ecology and silviculture, and economic. Economy, and also we have three very beautiful arboretums, which I really suggest you to visit if you ever come to Hungary. The research topic is obviously climate change is one of the main research that we do, and sustainable forest management and ecosystem services is a new topic, fairly new topic for us. Next one. So about agroforestry in Hungary, there's actually, we do have a history to it. We used to have flood-based agriculture in the past, before our river was made to be able to trade on it, you know, to, for the sheep. I don't know the proper word for it. So we used to have the curves, but now they are cut. But before, when the areas were flooded, we used they used to have fruit trees. And then when it was flooded, they did like some fishing, so like aquaculture. And when the water was away, then they could still do agricultural production. In the past, and then wood pastures, we still have some remaining. And there's a scientist at the Hungarian Academy of Sciences who's doing a lot of research on the wood pastures. And then shelter beds, we used to have them, especially in the 1950s and 60s, when they were like huge agricultural lands maintained by the state, basically. They were able to plan them because, as you probably know, shelter beds, you have the positive effects further away from the shelter bed itself, so you need bigger areas for these to be efficient from the point of crop yields. And then we have alicropping. The interesting thing is that, like, from a forestry point of view, they used to and they still plant it in some cases when they want, for example, to protect poplars from the wind. When it's planted in a sandy soil, it can really damage the trees, so they planted maize, for example, because it grows taller, and then it's basically a shelter for the small trees. And also, I think home gardens can be mentioned as agroforestry systems. For me, it's very interesting that when I read international literature, it, to me, I would classify like such a home garden an agroforestry system. And I think that in Western Europe, you cannot really see these gardens. I mean, I don't know if you can, I haven't really seen them, because most often you see like beautiful like rust and ornamentals. Whereas in Hungary, many people, even in cities, if they have a garden, they would produce their vegetables and some fruits. So how we came to research is that I believe Hungary was the first to implement a measure. So it was a subsidy for wood pastures, to establish wood pastures. And so the Minister of Agriculture realized the importance of, I think, this agricultural system. So this is how we also started to do the research in Forest Research Institute. Like, the project started in 2014. And there are some other projects going on. I don't know if you've heard about Andrea Viti. She works at the University of Sopron, where I also do my PhD. And so she does some work in AgForward and Agroof MM and Affinet. Whether, I don't know if you're familiar with these projects. No, you're not. It's about agroforestry networking, basically, and education. So about the little team that we have. So we got our Director General of NARIC. He thinks agroforestry is a priority topic, or it is actually, in our institution. We are actually, with this team, writing a book at the moment. It's going to be published soon about agroforestry, just like in general, for farmers and people to at least hear about it at all. And then there is Norbert Chomody, who is Strategy Deputy Director of NARIC. He used to be an attaché in Paris in an agricultural matter. And then we have the Director of the Forest Research Institution, Adina Borovic. My mentor is Joad Kesher. I'm saying a mentor because there's actually a program at NARIC. It's a researcher recruitment program, because we have a huge generation gap now in research, unfortunately. So they launched this program a few years ago, and this is how I could actually start working at the Forest Research Institute. And so he's my mentor as well, and he's in charge of the projects of agroforestry. And then two of my colleagues, he's Janos Rasho, they help me a lot in the fieldwork. And he's a biologist, and he just started his PhD as well. And Beatrix Bhakti, she's just about to finish her PhD studies, actually. And the three of us, four of us, we work at the plantation forestry department. So the project that we do, as I mentioned, the Minister of Agriculture launched this R&D&I program on agroforestry. So we willing to present demonstration sites, so we worked a lot on that to establish some sites or to actually do a survey on existing systems to be able to study them and to present them. And the ecosystem service that I mentioned, we are about to study. And then there is a project going on between Hungary and France to cooperate. It's because Fabian Balaki and Hélène Canet, the, who used to be the president of the French Agroforestry Association, they visited Hungary twice, and this is how we met. We took them to the fields, and they really enjoyed what they saw, and so they suggested me to actually apply for the scholarship to be able to work together, and the reason why I'm here. And then there is European Innovation Partnership. Have you heard about that one, maybe? It's a new project as well. The whole point is that you start, you get this fund if you work together with farmers. So you really do research in something that they are really interested in. And we are just trying to establish a group with these people. They are actually fruit growers. They have a very interesting way of growing fruits. They've been doing it for 20 years. They're basically self-sufficient. It's a very interesting thing what they do. Another thing is process network engineering is going to be a modeling work, and it's also just in the beginning. We're just going to work with another university. But to show some pictures and what the sites where we actually work on, I think for your group this could be the most interesting one, which my colleague planned in 98, Janos. He's the farmer, Zsigmond. So it was his dream to, out of his 5 hectares of land, I mean he has this 5 hectare here, but he has another 15 hectares, a little bit further away. He's an organic grower, and he wanted to have a bee pasture for the bees to feed them on the flowers. So it was an agriculture, the registration, the land registration, it was agricultural land, but then because he forested this area, it became 3 hectares of forest. And then you have 2 hectares of crops. We also have control sites because he produces the same crops, for example, maize, organic maize, in a field that's open field, so there are no trees around at all. He says that it's about 15% higher the yield that he can gain from this field. And so what we do is we do different kind of So we take soil samples, we want to see how the soil evolves since for 18 years or so, nearly 20 years, we got this land covered by forest. And then we also do some microclimate monitoring. We had a little publication, actually a little poster last year at the Third Agroforestry, European Agroforestry Conference in Montpellier. He's actually using the forest to, like, as fuel wood. Here you can see that he was just cutting it last, I think it was last week when we visited him. And eventually he's willing to move in there because he finds it really amazing and a nice place to be. Yes. So, some details about the structure of this shelter bed. It was, as I mentioned, planned to be a bee pasture, so there were 20 different species chosen. Sorry, it's in Hungarian. If anyone's interested in the tree species, I can tell later. So they were planted in a way that the canopy can absorb more light, let's say. So you have, if more light reaches the canopy, then you get more flowers as well. So it was a point to plant it in this way, and then we can, oh, we already measured the trees and we've been measuring them, and now we can say that the structure is good enough for it as a windbreak, so it does give shelter for the crops. And also these species were chosen in a way that they flower from February to September. So yes, Ellen and Fabian was very excited about this place. And of course there's a lot of like biodiversity, where I always see very cute life from rabbits, the hare, to deers, and it's a very pretty place to be. But then we have some alicropping experiments. This one is we cooperated with the Institute of Agriculture Engineering. This was research on crop leasing and like energy plantation, but that research was over. So we turned into an agroforestry demonstration site basically. So we have poplars here and black locust in these stands. And these are like their fields where we could do some control. We have different row and in-row spacing. And in the rows, we are planning to have triticale and vegetables. So there's also some research going on crop protection. With the University of Saint István, which is in the same town. So this is how it looked like, the black locust stand and the poplar stand. And this is after we cleared up, and here's this little crop protection research going on, with covering the film. Yes. And then another alicropping experiment is in Karsa. It's third university or fourth, right? I know, so we do try to work with many universities and to get more other scientists involved from other professions. It's different spacing. It's another hybrid poplar that we are actually testing because it's not in commercial use yet. And we have crop rotation in between, so four different crops in between. And then my PhD, my title at the moment is The Role of Agroforestry in Applying a Smart Sustainable Agriculture, which is very, very broad, and I wanted to be like this to find my way later on when I want to really investigate. And at this point it's producing berries in an alicropping system. It's because the leaves of the berries, they tend to burn lately, so the yield is decreasing. It's probably because of climate change. Now there is this great tunnels here to protect these plants, but the problem is because of these really crazy thunderstorms we have lately, the storm damaged these tunnels. And so we want to see if these tunnels could be replaced. The trees, for example, if this could work, but then you have to look at also the costs, the yields, and whether if there's competition and the shading effects. Now we have a little bit of a trouble because this was taken last year. Now this was taken last week or so. So we had again a crazy storm, and now all the tunnels are gone, and it's costing ten thousands of euros. So it's a big problem, I think. Now here you can see when we were planting. It was planted in April. And the berries are strawberry, raspberry, red currant, and mulberry. They also do breeding here. So it's also important. It's interesting for them. And so we used to have control under the tunnels and then open field, and it would be the parcels with the trees. This is how we planned it. There are the different species in rotations. This was taken in April, I believe, April, May. And now this was taken just before I left. It looks so ugly because it just got an irrigation system. So just that day they finished it. And that's why it's a little bit messy. But they are actually, I think they look quite good. And they look healthy so far. So good. And so the investigations that we're basically doing, most of our experimental sites is the water and nutrient cycle, soil monitoring, mainly soil moisture, and then obviously we look at the yields of dendromas and crop yields, and then crop protection, microclimate and light capture, carbon sequestration, the growing space we have to investigate. It's very important from plantation forestry. And in the longer run, we would like to see the tree crop compatibility and growth rate analysis we are planning to do, because some of my colleagues are on that. So basically, this is what we do in short. I realize that it's somewhat different than what you do. I really like your approach as well. And so I would be very happy if you have any questions or suggestions.